This video is the beginning of a 10-day vlogging challenge. I've decided to give myself a challenge for the next 10 days. So I have, I think, roughly 10 more days home, and then I'm back to school teaching. I have about 5 or 6 videos on the go right now, and nothing's being released because of one issue or another. I need to get on top of all of that, and I thought, you know, one way to kind of help me pull my finger out and get things moving would be to set myself with a 10-day challenge to try and release one video every day for the next 10 days. We're going to see how that goes. I don't know if I can do it. I'd like to. I know that this is going to cause a drastic change in my viewership and maybe my subscribership. I'm well on my way to 5,000 subscribers, which is nuts, phenomenal. And it's crazy to see how quickly, you know, I reached like 1,000 and 2,000 and 3,000, 4,000 and 5,000. It just seems that they're coming faster and faster and faster. So I'm very grateful for you to that you've subscribed to my videos. I also want to give a very big shout out and a thank you to Nerdville. I'm re-recording this intro because in the initial video, and it just so happens I'm wearing the same t-shirt and the same cap, except I've had my hair cut since the next bit of video you're gonna see. But I used his real name in the video that he sent me, and I thought, you know what? I don't know if he wants me using his real name, so I'm just using his handle, his YouTube handle, his username, and I thought I would say a big shout out and a thank you to Nerdville. So thank you for that, sir. Love your videos, keep up the great work, and I'm looking forward to seeing what we can do together. I've got some embers of some beginning ideas. I think I know where I want to take my channel, this particular channel. So I'll leave it at that. I'm going to cut here now for the video that I recorded previously. Really nice guy in the UK. We do similar stuff. He like what I do on YouTube or create on YouTube, and I like his videos too. Very informative. We got very similar interests. I'm very jealous of some of the stuff he's got, and in fact, I've bookmarked. That's the phone starting. I've bookmarked some items that I want to purchase that he actually has. Laser engraver, 3D printer, and what have you. So he's been designing and building some devices to help recharge 18650 batteries, or at least to kind of speed up the process. And I've got my spin on those that I'd like to kind of put forth as well. But right now, so a big thumbs up, go check out his video. Click on that link right there, if you would. Go check him out, brilliant stuff. You know, it's kind of an honor really to see that other people like some of the things that I put out. I do try my best at times, at times. I found my Doctor Who screwdriver. I'm making a new unit, a new table with an island that goes underneath, and then when we need it, we pull it out, leaving the table on top in place. This doesn't do that, so it leaves a lot to be desired. I'm doing a hard reset of my AT&T Samsung Galaxy Note. I want to clean it out and use it as a subscriber count for my YouTube channel readout on my storage shelf. So I just discovered how to do it. Dishwasher is running right now, but look at the bone broth. It's It's got some nice fatty deposits on top. It's simmering away. And it tastes absolutely delicious. So I'm excited to bottle that up in some more mason jars. Look, these are some of the jars I got. And then tomorrow I'm gonna go down to the butcher's to get some more grass-fed bones then as well. It's funny, I never thought I would be going back to eating animal products again, but you know, just for me, it's one of the easier ways, it seems, to kick diabetes and high blood pressure. So I'll do what I need to do for now and adjust it as I go down the road. I'm uploading the final edits to the wedding invitation RSVP site for Dee and my wedding, September the 25th. I think I'll put on the lights. So, a little bit non-eventful, the lights right now. Big news, I guess. Even the printer is giving it a little fanfare. I've noticed a few people that I follow, that I enjoy to follow, have started doing daily vlogs. It's a commitment, and it's something that I've been thinking about on and off. And I only have, I think, 2 weeks left before I go back to school to teach. So I thought with these last 2 weeks, I'd dip my toes into the water to see what it's like vlogging daily, to see if I can put an improved schedule of uploaded videos. I'm trying to make sure that, A, I got content that's worthy, B, the production value doesn't hit, you know, take a hit too badly. But more than anything else, I don't want to bore anyone. Look, every time I put up a video, I lose a bunch of people and I gain a bunch of people. I'm getting on for the 2 million views mark right now. And that is absolutely phenomenal. 2 million views. Unreal. I think what I'm going to do is, over time, I'm going to set certain days of the week to be certain types of videos. I've seen some content creators do this quite successfully. Then that will let you know that on certain days, the videos that maybe you're interested in are the days that you can go to my channel and see that content. You'll also know then that, you know, I'm not putting out the same boring stuff day in, day out. So that, you know, that's one thing to kind of think about. Right now, I'm just going to do whatever for the next 2 weeks. It's a challenge I've set myself. Not sure how well it's going to go. I got some big stuff lined up this week. I have to build from scratch a kitchen island that I've designed. But it needs to be an island that pulls out on wheels, and then when it's done, it pushes back. But on top of the island is another table that holds the microwaves, some mixing utensils, and, you know, pictures and stuff. I want that table to stay there all the time. But underneath slides the island. So I'm going to make a first one, and depending on how easy this goes, this might be something that I make more of and possibly sell on the internet. The one that we purchased was $1,300. It doesn't have wheels. It's pretty to look at, but it sucks as far as utility of it. So you'll see. So if you want one of these, I've yet to work out the price and how long it takes me to make, blah, blah, blah. But this might be something that I'm willing to make throughout the year if you want one. The only trouble is, it's gonna be massive. So I would probably have to make these to order. I gotta get some extra money coming in. I got lots of stuff I wanna do. I live in northern New Jersey. I wanna get an e-bike. I wanna get an electric bike. But the laws here are so ambiguous. If you look up here and there, it says you gotta have this, you gotta have that. Motor vehicles need to approve of the vehicle you got. And there's a lot of money to dump into a bike and not be allowed to use it, you know? And I don't want to just ride it around the housing complex where we live. We live in a little townhouse complex. So I need to speak to the police nearby. I need to speak to the town hall and maybe go to DMV and try and clear this up. So I'm going to get information about the electric bikes. Legally, where do I stand? What insurance do I need to get? What coverage do I need to get? So information on all of that. I have tons of 18650 batteries. I want to make my own 48 volt 12 amp hour battery packs so that I can make an additional battery pack to go with the one that comes with the bike. So maybe I could go 30 miles out and then come back 30 miles. So we'll see. So all of that. Those of you that know or have noticed, I'm down presently 25 pounds in weight. I've been dropping weight like no one's business. I got rid of my high blood pressure. I'm no longer on high blood pressure medication. I'm slowly kicking my diabetes. My blood sugar is in a really good range. Life's getting better all the time, so things are improving and I'm on the right trajectory. You know, there's a lot of people I see on here and you see what they have for their breakfast, lunch, dinner. I kind of want to do the same, but I want to have a healthier kind of twist on things. I'm doing more of it's slightly paleo, but it's more ketogenic, more of a keto diet, which is high fat, low to medium protein, very low carbs. Carbs like once or twice a week just to kind of help boost sleeping abilities and what have you. But I am a diabetic, type 2, so I am healing myself one day at a time. So I want to walk you through that as well. I'm a graphic artist. I'm a high school teacher. I teach graphic arts, web, advertising, you name it, I do it all. I love it all. But I love working with wood as well, so maybe you'll see me do a bunch of that. Stay tuned. And if you do like these videos, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe below. I'd love to see more of you. Let's interact. Those of you that don't interact nicely will be removed. I recently proposed to my fiance, my now fiance, my then girlfriend of 10 years. We're getting married in just over 4 weeks, about 5 weeks from now. That is going to be live streamed. I'm not sure if it's going to be live streamed on Periscope, YouTube, or Facebook, or Google. So we'll see. We'll see what the dealio is the closer we get to the date. And I'll also release the website as well when that's ready. If you want to leave like a nice comment for D and I. Anyway, that's it for now. Let's see what else I'm going to do. One of the things I'm trying to do is I have an orange clamshell Mac laptop. Now the battery I kind of replaced and fixed. And there's a video, one of the early videos I made here. It kind of worked okay. I didn't do a great job putting it back into the battery casing. But if I spent more time, I could fix it. But it does work and I can get on the internet and what have you. But I'm thinking what I'm going to do is create something to put behind me as a display. So as I talk, it shows my subscriber count. I've seen a couple, three YouTubers do it to date. And I thought, you know what, I could do it a little bit differently with an old orange clamshell laptop, Mac laptop. That might be fun. I think it's a G3. Sorry, quite annoyingly, I actually have the air conditioning on in this room, and it's a nasty window unit. But I'm actually looking for, look at me all silhouetted out. I'm actually looking for the laptop, because I haven't seen it for a while, to be honest. I don't think I threw it away. Why would I? I'm a Mac guy. So here's one of the issues I got, right? So this screen is 10 feet wide. And although it's great, I need to make it so that it hinges from the ceiling and it opens out, or it rolls down, it unfolds. Because right now, this has been covered up for so long, well over a year, I forgot all the really cool stuff that's behind here. And there's another green screen behind it. So let me take you on a little behind the green screen tour. So this is another very large, this is a black backdrop. I've got all of these really thick, nice carrying cases. That's a Canova carrying case for my 40-odd inch slider, but I got some really nice carrying cases down here. Tons of different bits and pieces. I found my Incredible Hulk, my Dragon Ball Z bobblehead. I found my Doctor Who screwdriver. I found my Bluetooth keyboard. I found my soldering iron. I found a cool little, is it iGriffin? It's like a silicone base, it glows blue. It has software, you press it and it's a button, you can turn it left and right, and you can make it do all different sorts of things. I've got my Doctor Who and TARDIS travel mug. So if I go behind here, I got my emergency light, which still works. I got my kettle, Ethernet cables. It's not for making pasta, this is for clay, but you could use for pasta. Let me make some space. These are very temperamental because they can fall down. So move that over. Move this over as much as I dare, and I'm gonna squeeze in here. So I got a cassette player deck, which I use to play, sadly, which I use to play some of my cassettes, and I have so many. This is a cord device, which it wobbles your feet. It wobbles your feet to, wow, I need that device here. So I got another outlet for over by me. I'll move this over here. Ooh. Let's see. Matrix sculpture. Lights, emergency stuff. Camp matches. Angel, lion's head that I sculpted. Home movies of old. Another little sculpture that I made. I sculpted this dragon's head. It's one of my early videos. There's the box for my 5D. I forgot I even had that. I sold that 5D. I should have gave the box as well. Darn it. My daughter got me this. Let me turn up. Let me see if it works. Yeah, it's dead. Needs new batteries. Just leave that there though. I got lots of little diaries and books that I need to fill in. Matches for the bathroom. Need those. I got some cool shit, man. Goblets that I used to make. I used to make these and sell these wine goblets. This is one of the first ones I made. I got the Incredible Hulk back there. It's too dark to see. I might grab that out. Why hide it? I got a shotgun mic in there. All this stuff. Coming out. Make way. Put my Superman. I think that's the WB Superman. Incredible Hulk. I just admire. I used to go to Toys R Us and I used to buy the toys for myself. And I used to tell my kids, don't touch. See what else. Got a shotgun mic in here. I mean, you know, big deal with this. I mean, I don't. I got better stuff now. I got all my radio control gear, my servos, testers. I got a USB TARDIS here. See, this is why I need to. I got a breadboard. This is why I need access to all this stuff, because I forget about the cool crap that's back here. Boy, oh boy. Radio controls. Got a little Buddha thing down here. Incredible. But I don't see any laptop. So although I want to make this more available, I think this could work if I had it on like a roller system on a servo, like a motor or some sort. Let's see if I can get out. It's kind of cool, right? USB TARDIS. It's my lady, she knows me. All right, so I don't see my laptop in here. Plus I have not shown you what's in my cabinet back here. About 10 years ago now, I used to make some devices that I used to sell on eBay. That year, the year that I did that, I made $42,000 on eBay. Some of them were thousands of percent profit. It was absolutely ridiculous. Actually, I got a word out. I'm not sure. I'd have to do the math on that. I'm not exactly sure how much profit, but it was crazy. It was the parts used to cost me about 75 cents, 83 cents, depending on if I did certain things myself, or I had them shipped in from somewhere like Pakistan or China. And some of these devices would sell for about $95 a piece. I think people still sell them, make them and sell them on eBay. Anyway, this stuff would be good for my behind my head display when I make the videos at my desk. So I'm gonna take this. I'll have to dust off a few. I got my hands full right now with superheroes. And is Hulk really a superhero? I guess he is, right? Hulk smash. It's a bit too green, this one. This laptop, it stands out like a sore thumb. And do you think I can find it? It's not in this room unless, I think I'd know it if I brought it over. I had all my stuff in the bedroom. Dee had me move it because she was about to kill me. And now it's dumped all just on the side of my desk. So now I got to go through everything. It's kind of forcing me to go through the final bits. So not too long ago, I did a review of two types of battery charger for the 18650 batteries. Well, actually, they're for several different types of batteries, rechargeable batteries, but it was a giveaway. I have 3 or 4 units to give away. I was just waiting for shipping money because I have to wait until I get paid so I can actually announce a winner, and then I'll have money to ship. So I'm going to, next video, I'm going to announce the winners for that, and then 2 weeks time when I get paid on a Friday, I will ship those out. But for now, I'm recharging this little lovely device. I reviewed this not too long ago. This is so light. This jump starts my car with ease. I used it to charge my phone the other day, so I'm just topping it back up. It's nice to have it all topped up. And I made, not too long ago, some bone broth. It looks a bit dodgy there because that's fat, that's bits of spices and other stuff, plus a little bit of frozen chunk that's still floating around. I actually have more that's on the go right here. That's all garlic on the top and what have you. So that stuff is simmering away. I need to stir it up. But we went out for breakfast this morning, so I had eggs and a few tablespoons of home fries, which are like roasted chopped up potatoes basically, or pan fried type of deal potatoes. But what I'm going to do is this is bone broth, and I'm going to heat this up, but I'm going to get a little sieve so I can kind of clean out some of the gunk that's in it. I'm going to pour like half. That's good. So I made, last night when I got home, about 1:30 in the morning, I took off the simmer some bone broth that I'd made. I'm using the bones one more time to make more bone broth. But I bottled up a bunch of bone broth in these little handy dandy jars, and I'll take these to school with me, and I'll heat them up and drink them at school for lunch, or at least that's part of my lunch. So let's get a spoon and stir this stuff. You know, these bones are truly getting utilized. They're breaking down. You know, this is an 8.5-quart pot, so probably tonight I'll add another liter of water. It will boil down, simmer down, simmer down now. And it's an 8.5-quart crock pot, which is fantastic for me. And no more using the blender for my coffee, because I found, or my fiance did, Dee did, she found the hand blender. So fantastic, I can make my bulletproof coffee. Well, it's, let's be clear, it's not bulletproof coffee, because I'm not using bulletproof coffee beans by any means. Ooh, that rhymes. but I'm using Starbucks, which could possibly have mycotoxins, but I'm doing the next best thing, and I'm just adding 2 tablespoons of grass-fed butter to that. So that's my coffee. So I'm gonna bring this bone broth to the simmer. And of course, as I do that, what happens is I simmer off some of the water, and what will be left behind is some of the goodness. I'm not gonna boil it, I'm just gonna simmer it. I'm gonna set the timer for 5 minutes. I've set it on my number 4, which usually that's good for me. And that will reduce down for 5 minutes. You know, the flavor is already pretty awesome, so I don't need to do too much. So a few things I need to do this week. We got a brand new fridge. I need to hook up the water line and tap into hopefully I can find a copper water line to tap into. So I got to pull out the dishwasher, tap into the line, run the hose behind, connect the water filter. I'm sorry, guys. Sorry, guys. It's okay, mommy. Sorry, guys. I just startled the cats. They run for their lives. Let's block some of that sun. So, you know, right now, it's a functioning unit, but it has no water hooked up to it. And the water needs to be filtered. So I have water, ice, and that needs to get working. So that'd be nice once it's all done. This needle valve needs to be installed. Then on top of that, I have this 20-foot length, 1/4-inch inlet. It's way bigger than it was needed, but for like 12 feet to 20 feet, the price difference was negligible. So I decided to get the 20. So this week, I'm gonna connect that to that, the water line at least. This looks small, but it's not. That is about 6 feet long. I don't know why it looks so wide. The lens is like a wide angle in this thing. It makes it look small. But this is about 6 feet. So I'm making a new unit, a new table with an island that goes underneath. And then when we need it, we pull it out, leaving the table on top in place. This doesn't do that. So it leaves a lot to be desired. So this we're gonna move into the living room. And I'm going to build a new unit styled a little bit like this, but I'm going to make something that's a little bit more modern, let's say. So I'm also going to be building that in the next probably 2 days from now. But the key thing is I want to try and leave it interesting enough for you. Look at Boo. You're a good boy, buddy. My kitty cat. This boy's so smart, he's like a dog. All right, Boo. You my boy? You my Bugsy boy? So I've made a lot of health revelations these last months. And stuff that I've been learning about a year. For about the last year now. Mimi. It's stuff I've been learning about for about the last year. And, you know, knowledge truly is power. If you can... It's pretty sad what the kids these days are eating day in and day out, and they don't realize it. And they're setting themselves up for failure big time. They don't realize it right now, because right now they're getting along just fine. Their lives are just fine. But a lot of them, if not many of them, most of them, are going to end up with type 2, type 1 diabetes, and they're going to be praying, wishing that they changed a lot of what they did right now, but they're not going to listen. Because you're invincible, right? I was once invincible. I used to do some crazy, crazy stuff because no one was better than me, if you know what I mean. But we all grow up. Anyway, let's have a look. So this is cooling down. My broth is cooling down. Let's take this upstairs and go look for my laptop. Oh, look what I got for upstairs in the office. I want to put liquid in here and then, or maybe like a gel, and then an LED that fluctuates color so that the whole thing kind of glows in different colors, and keep it on my display case upstairs. Got my bone broth. So Dee thinks, she thinks that the laptop might be in our bedroom on a chair with some clothes. So I'm going to look. And she's right, because I see a power cable. Let's set you up for the unveiling.
It is, there it is. Fantastic. This means I need to reorganize the shelves in my office. Fantastic!
Well, the good thing is right now at least is that the batteries are charging. Now I gotta see where I can fit it. I gotta see where I can fit it behind me. I think over in this space over here would be good. You'll see. I'm gonna have my subscriber count on there if I can. I'll see if the PHP or whatever scripts that are running on the website that I need to run will work on this clamshell iBook. I think it's a G3. I'd have to look up the info. Look, I just got a gray screen right now. It's great how you open up and Google looks, because it's so simple, it just looks fine. The YouTube live count doesn't work on the old clamshell iBook, but my digital clock does, so I can peruse the web on this, although it's just way too slow. It's not practical, but what I can do, this is a a very good word processor. It does get on Wi-Fi, but not this Wi-Fi. I got another older router in the house that I really don't want to use. So if I need it to get on the internet, I'll go Ethernet. I've unplugged it for now. I think I'm just going to mount it on the shelf and leave it set up as a digital clock. But not right yet, because I need to make some space up here or up there. Somewhere. So, I think that's what I'm going to do. But I do have another device. My old phone. Can't remember what it is now. Note. It's the Android. It's the... forget what it's called. Dang it. But a large phone nonetheless. That should be able to be powered up, recharged, and on the internet using the Wi-Fi. Alright. Let's see what we can do with this channel. Like I said, probably in the months ahead, I'll probably have so that different days are for different types of videos. Right, thank you for watching. That's my new phone, my old phone being charged up and turning on for the first time. I'll let you know in the next vlog if I can get like a little freestanding phone. Maybe I'll make a little wooden stand for the phone that can sit on my shelf, get on the internet via the wireless network, and show a live YouTube subscriber count for my channel. That might be cool. I got some electronic kits as well that I want to build. There's a clock and some other bits and pieces, a digital microscope and what have you. I got some stuff coming in from banggood.com, which, if you know it, they sell a lot of cheap kind of overseas electronic items. So that's kind of neat. I got so much stuff here to review. It's ridiculous. How ridiculous is it? It's redonkulous. It's that ridiculous. Anyway, the countdown is on. September 25th. I'm getting married. It's going to be cool. It's going to be exciting. And it's going to be live streamed. I'm just not sure what the best format is going to be. You know, YouTube, Google, Facebook, Periscope, etc., etc. So, anyway, all right. No catchphrase. I don't have a catchphrase.